Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to run C programs within Visual Studio Code. So I am making a series of videos where I am showing how to use Visual Studio Code for some of the very popular languages like C or C++, Java, JavaScript, PHP or Python. You know, all these different languages, I am showing how to use Visual Studio Code for all these different languages. So to watch this entire playlist, I can guarantee if you watch this entire playlist, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you still face any issues in middle, you can always comment in our comment sections. I'll try my best to help you. So here in this video, I'm going to use latest version of GCC compiler, which is version 14.1.0. So you need to download basically two software. One is GCC compiler and Visual Studio Code. So you need to go to your favorite browser and then you need to search over here Visual Studio Code. So you need to download your Visual Studio Code, go to download and download our Visual Studio Code. So thank you for downloading. Our Visual Studio is rightly started downloading. Alright, so that is our first software. Next software that we'll need is, you need to go to a new tab and then you need to just simply type GCC 14 download. Alright, and hit enter. So that's going to show you all these different links. So you need to go to this GCC W64 download link. Don't worry, I am going to provide this link in the description, so you can directly use that link to land over here. And once you are here, you'll be able to see, if you scroll down, you'll be able to see all these different compilers are there to download. So from here, I'm going to download the latest version, which is 14 at the time of making up this video. Maybe when you'll be watching, you might see a different version, maybe version 15 or 16, and maybe it totally depends upon what time you are watching this video. Don't worry, whatever steps I am going to show you on this video will be pretty much same. Alright, so no need to worry. So you need to download one release version from here. I am going to download the latest one, which is 14.1.0 at the time of making of this video. So I am going to click on this link and immediately it's going to start downloading our GCC compiler. So here you can see that our compiler is rightly started downloading, right? So I have already downloaded both the softwares. So I'll go to my download directory, and here you can see that our GCC compiler along with Visual Studio Code both are rightly downloaded over here. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to extract this zip folder. So right click and click on extract all and click on extract. So that's going to start extracting our GCC compiler. You can see it is rightly started doing that. So, you know, let it get done in the background. So by the time this gets done, let's install our Visual Studio Code. So just simply double click on Visual Studio Code, the .exe, and let's install it. So it will ask you, it will first tell you this license agreement. You need to accept this license agreement. Click on next. So here our Visual Studio Code is going to be installed. Click on next. Visual Studio Code folder it's going to create. Totally fine. Click on next. And let's check all these different options and click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install, and there you go, preparing to install, and our installation will be begun. So it will take a couple of minutes. So after that, I'm going to again come back to this video. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Visual Studio Code is rightly installed along with our GCC compiler files is also extracted over here. So you can close this folder. So here is completion of Visual Studio Code. You can, you know, click on, just check this, launch Visual Studio Code, and click on finish. So that's going to launch our Visual Studio Code over here. You can minimize this for the time being, and let's see the extracted folder. So this is our extracted folder of this GCC compiler. So if you go inside that folder, you can see all these different files are over here, right? So what you need to do is you need to just simply right click on this folder and go to show more options to rename this folder to something little short. So like GCC, then the version number only, and then you need to just simply right click and cut this folder and go to your C drive and paste that folder over here. So you can see that our folder is rightly pasted over here, a GCC version 14.1.0 on our C drive. Alright, and then you need to go inside this bin folder, and here again you can see lot of files and folders over here. So what you need to do is, need to click on this folder path and then need to copy this path over here. Alright, so this C folder GCC version 14.1.0/bin/folder/path is what you need to copy. And then you need to minimize this folder and go to search to type environ over here. So you are going to open this edit the system environment variables. And here click on environment variables. So that will open this environment variable window. Here under system variables, you'll see path over here. So you click on that path and then you need to click on edit. So that will open this edit the environment variable window. Here you need to just simply click on new and then you need to right click and then you need to paste that GCC version 14.1.2/bin/folder/path over here. And then click on outside and click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now, if you go to search and just simply type cmd to open our command prompt, and within command prompt, if you just simply type gcc space --version and hit enter, you can see that our latest version of GCC compiler, that is version 14.1.2, is rightly installed and that is clearly showing over here. Alright, so you need to close this folder and let's go back to your Visual Studio Code. So this is the interface of Visual Studio Code. So what you need to do is you need to go to file and then you need to click on this open folder. So that will show you this folder. Let's go to our desktop and let's create a new folder. Like let's name this folder like cprog and just simply select that folder and click on select folder. So what it's going to do is it's going to open our cprog folder right under explorer. You can always click on this I trust the authors and all. So here is our cprog folder. So you need to create a new file and let's give the file name as hello.c. I'm going to create a C program, so I'm going to give the file name as hello.c. If you want to create a C++ program, you need to just simply give .cpp for that. And here I'm going to write a simple hello world code. So just type #include. So I'll just fast forward it and write the code. So you just simply write a simple hello world code over here and then you need to go to extensions and then you need to just simply search over here C. So that will show you this, you know, this popular extension pack. So if you click on that, you can see that there are three extensions packs. So all these things are going to be installed. So it is developed by Microsoft only, totally safe. Just simply click on install and it's going to start installing our all these three different extensions. So you need to have active internet connections also. So you can see that all these three different extensions are now rightly installed. So you can switch to all these different extensions. So if you go to the C or C++ themes and if you want to change this color, so if you click on the set color and you can change it to probably light, so that will, you know, show you something bright like this. I usually code at night, so I usually prefer something like dark. You can choose whichever you want. And here is our code. So what you need to do is you need to just simply save this file and then you need to go to terminal and then you need to open this new terminal over here. So that will open our terminal over here. So you need to change this from PowerShell. You need to click on this drop down and then you need to make it to command prompt. So you are going to use command prompt only to run this code. So here if you just simply type gcc then your file name, which is hello.c, so hello.c, hit enter, that's going to successfully compile our program. When it gets successfully compiled, if you go to this file explorer, you'll be able to see a a.txt file, you know, getting generated. So to run this file, so you need to just simply type a over here, that is basically this exe's file name a, and hit enter, and there you go. You can see the output clearly shown on our console, hello world, right? So in this way, you can easily use Visual Studio Code for writing C or C++ program, and you can use this latest version of GCC compiler for compiling our C or C++ code. Alright, so that's basically all about this video. I have recently started this Geeky Syntax channel. So here also regularly I am posting coding related videos. So please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel along with our main channel. And also if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video and God bless you all.